Come and sit down. You look a bit white. Are you all right?
Yeah, I'm all right now.
Let's have a look at your arm. It's a bit red. It's going to be painful. What shall I do with it?
Oh, it's not much. A bit of soap on it'll do. I can't really remember what to do with burns.
Right, well, I'll just pop down the bathroom then and get some, shall I? Won't be a minute.
God.
I got this scented muff. Do you think it'll be alright?
Oh, it'll do.
Right, let's have a look at your arm. Right, I ran it under the tap, so it should be a bit soft, and I'll do it ever so gently. Alright? You're a brave girl.
I don't feel very brave. I really don't, Cliff. Oh, I think I feel rather sick.
Right, all over now. Do you need me to get you anything else? Don't upset yourself, lovely.
Where is he?
In my room.
What's he doing?
On the bed, reading, I think. Is that better?
Bless you.
You know, in spite of everything, I don't think I can live on my own again. You sort of get fond of people. It's worse luck.
I don't think I could do any more with love. I can't take it on.
You're too young to start giving up. Too young and too lovely. Perhaps I better put a bandage on that, eh?
They're over there. You know, I keep looking back and I can't remember what it's like to be young. You're really young. Jamie said the same thing to me the other day, but I pretended to be listening because I didn't want to hurt him. I knew what he meant. I suppose it would have been easy to say, yes, darling, I know what you mean. I know exactly what you're feeling. It's the little things that are impossible with us.
You know, I'm wondering how much longer I can watch you two tear the insides out of each other. It's pretty ugly sometimes.
You wouldn't seriously think about leaving us, would you?
I suppose not.
I think I'm frightened. If only you knew what was going to happen.
Right, give it here. Now yell out to the hair again, okay?
Cliff.
Yeah, what is it, lovely?
You see, I'm pregnant.
I'll need the scissors for that. Well, that is something, isn't it? When did you find this out?
A few days ago. Bit of a shock, really.
Yeah, dare say.
After 3 years of married life, I have to get called out now.
None of us infallible, I suppose. May seem surprised, though.
It was always out of the question, what with this place and no money, and, oh, everything. He always resented it, you know. What can you do?
Haven't you told him yet?
Not yet.
What are you going to do?
I've no idea.
Right, is that too tight?
It's fine, thanks.
Is it...
Too late to avert the situation. I'm not certain yet. Maybe not. If not, we won't have a problem, will we?
And if it's too late? Why don't you tell him now? After all, he does love you and you don't need me to tell you that.
Can't you see? He'll suspect my motives at once. Okay, like tonight. We'll make love and then later on we lie awake. Just waiting for that little light to come through the window and dreading it. In the morning, he'd feel hoaxed, like I tried to kill him in the worst way possible. He'd watch me get bigger and bigger every day. I couldn't dare look at him.
You might have to face it, lovely.
Jimmy's got his own morality, as you know, what my mother calls loose. It's pretty free, of course, but it's harsh too. You know, it's funny. We never slept together before we were married.
It certainly is now and then.
We only knew each other for such a short time and it went at such a pace. We didn't really get the opportunity.
You know, I've never heard you talking about something like this before. You'd be quite pleased.
Yeah, he would. Do you think he's right?
What about?
Oh, everything.
Well, I suppose he and I think a lot about the same things. Because we're alike in some ways. And we both come from working people, if you like. I know, some of his mother's relatives are pretty posh. And he hates them just as much as he hates yours. Anyway, get on with me because I'm common. Common as dirt, of course. That's me.
Think I should tell him?
He'll be all right.